experience been like now, fast forwarding to actually getting to the playing time and game time? What has this experience been like for you? And has the dust settled at all from some of these moments that you've experienced early on, the Steph moment, the LeBron moments, et cetera?
Yeah, for sure. I think now it's more trying to stay locked in on staying here. Now that the, I guess you want to call it honeymoon phase or whatever, has kind of subsided, and now I'm actually changed my thought process to I belong. Just making sure that I'm coming in every day, being serious about my process and taking every day as an advantage to get better as a person and as a leader and not just an athlete. And then just trying to have fun. I think a lot of people get to this level and sometimes they get caught up in a lot of the other things, but this game is always about having fun. That's one thing my dad has always told me, and making sure I'm getting better as not just an athlete, but a human.
Have you thought about those moments when you might get called up to join the Lakers on the road or, you know, at home, and what that will look like for you and just your mindset approaching that?
Every day, I think about it every day, actually. I dream about it. I wake up every day thinking that maybe that day will be the day. And every time I had that dream, is okay, when I get there, it's just gonna be like I'm the spark, you know, I'm the energy, I'm the joy, I'm what the team will need for that night. And then I'll fly back and come back and do my G League job and keep going about my business. But when that does happen, I know I'll be ready, because I've been trying to prepare myself mentally to be as prepared as I can, and then physically just being ready, because I've already been warned that that's very unexpected. You know, I could be mentally getting ready for the game Saturday against Salt Lake City, but they call me Friday and say they need me to suit up against the Sixers, and I got to play Friday and Saturday. So just making sure that when that moment does happen, that I'm ready for both the NBA and the G League game, because both games are still an opportunity for me to show that I'm a great player for a franchise.
Have you talked to Jalen and Maxwell about doing that? What have they told you about that experience that they went through last year of doing that very same thing? I'll see Jalen get a couple minutes on Friday night, then they're down here with me on Saturday night, hooping as well. Have he talked to you at all about that? What's
just,
that like?
Just be ready. I mean, everybody's been saying the same thing. Be ready. This role that I'm in is very unexpected. You never know when they're going to need you. You never know when they're going to call you. But when they do, they're going to be expecting you to be ready, and there's no excuses. So just go out there and have fun. Give it all you got.
How do you stay present? Obviously, big dreams, want to be with the big club. But how do you stay present in the moment?
Reminding myself that this is a dream. This is an opportunity to continue to not only show the Lakers, but any other franchise. And every day is an opportunity to capitalize on that moment. So whether that's today, where we're just kind of walking through before media day, or tomorrow we're game prepping for Salt Lake City, you just never know who's watching, who's talking, or what questions people are asking. So you always have to be ready, because that moment could be the opportunity. And even if it's not on the court, it could just be, oh, Quincy's here every morning early, or Quincy's eating breakfast and then he's going about his treatment. It could just be that, or it could just be the scouts are there at the game on Saturday. Okay, we're excited to see how this kid is playing against his first G League game after the preseason he had, and is he still on a high from Steph and LeBron? And, you know, you never know, but you just always got to be ready, because every moment could be that one moment.
You said being that spark, potentially. Is that, what does that look like? Is that just the shooting, or is there more to it than just that?
No, I'm more than just a scorer. And I've been trying to make sure I prove that notion coming out of college. That's what a lot of people deem me as coming out of college. I can only affect the game by scoring, but I love to have fun. I love to smile. I love to rebound. I just love to bring positive energy to the group, you know, because there's always a positive in every situation. So it's just people like me who need to bring that out of people and recognize that you got to change your perspective.
There have been a lot of people over the last few weeks who've really enjoyed this moment for you. It's been covered on ESPN, things like
crazy.
That. What's that been like for you, to see people enjoy this for you?
It's crazy. It's a lot of people that have been reaching out just saying that I'm like real genuine, and I don't even know how to respond to that, because I just feel like I'm being myself. But it's my dad talk about it. My grandma actually just texted me last night when I showed her my new necklace. I have my family's name across my neck on my new gold chain. And she said, "What's my celebrity relative doing?" I'm like, "Nah, Mama, I'm just playing a video game like what I always do." So it's honestly surreal, because I'm still the same person without the media coverage. It just happens to be that I gained like 60,000 followers and I have all this attention now. But it's honestly, it's insane.
People seem happy for you.
Yeah, they are, and I appreciate that. But that doesn't define who I am as a person, because at the end of the day, I still have to handle my business. It's not like the Lakers are listening to the media, the coaches aren't listening to the media. It's all about what do I do every day to put myself into a position to succeed.
How are your teammates reacting to you, or both from the G League level and the NBA level, on your big personality? How are they handling all that?
I mean, they kind of make jokes. Like, as you see, I have my Under Armours on my feet. They kind of joke that I think that I'm Steph Curry, and just Under Armour stuff, boxes always come into my locker. So they just kind of joke with me about that. But I just try to remind them, like, none of that really matters to me, because at the end of the day, I have to lace my shoes up and go produce.
All right, thank you.